Almost 5,000 kilometers of coastline between the Indian Ocean and the Pacific. Malaysia is home to the best of Asia and the craziest. Colonial heritage in bustling cities with laid-back people. Malaysia is full of natural wonders. Endless beaches and traditional villages. The country of around 32 million people has been independent from the British since 1957 and has been a liberal multi-ethnic state ever since. The mix of cultures makes Malaysia unique. A quarter of the inhabitants have Chinese roots. 50% are Malays. 7% are Indians. They all live together peacefully. Houses of worship of almost all the world's major religions are often located in the immediate vicinity. Mosque, Buddhist temple, Hindu temple, and Christian church. In the west of the country lies the Matang mangrove forest. It covers 40,000 hectares. Mangroves are considered trees of the sea because they can tolerate salt water. In the village of Kuala Sepetang, a rare product is made from mangroves. Sea coal is what it's called here. It smolders in 350 ovens. And they need a daily supply, fresh mangrove wood. Iwan Mohd is a foreman in one of the coal factories.
It's quite dangerous. The boat could be damaged because the water level is still low. But we have to leave now, otherwise we won't have time to get back.
The transport boat can only get through the swampy area at high tide. The harvesting team has already prepared the mangrove trunks. The two woodcutters discuss the situation. They noticed that there are particularly many mosquitoes today. They wouldn't walk around without headgear. And an incense spiral also helps. But the mosquitoes are not the biggest danger.
Always keep your eyes open and don't step in the mud. Malayan pit vipers are lurking everywhere here. It's the most dangerous snake in the swamp. Its venom is deadly. I think even stronger than that of the cobra. Working here is really very dangerous.
Mangrove wood is particularly hard and therefore ideal for high-quality charcoal.
I am satisfied. The quality is good. Few knot holes and very smooth. The Japanese love the charcoal from it. They alone order hundreds of tons every month. They use it for barbecues or for medical products.
Now the logs have to be loaded quickly so that the boat doesn't get stuck on the way back. Sea charcoal from the Matang forest is in demand worldwide. the best quality grade is used for air filters, catalytic converters, or medical products. Malaysia is in the tropics, just north of the equator. The eastern part on the island of Borneo is sparsely populated. The western part on the Malay Peninsula is the center of the country. The sea route Strait of Malacca runs through here. The city of Malacca has always had a strategic importance and attracted people from all over the world. There is a Portuguese quarter, the Dutch square, and English colonial buildings. Today, Malay, Chinese, and Indians live here. The people are known for their business acumen and inventiveness. It's precisely these qualities that have given the cycle rickshaw a comeback in Malacca in recent years. The more colorful, the better. This year, comic book and fairy tale characters are the order of the day. Ramli Ismail is planning a completely new design for his rickshaw for the season. Up to now, he had relied on Mickey Mouse, and he was right on the money. His rickshaw was in constant use.
Now the brakes are completely gone. Many passengers simply are too heavy. It really affects the brake pads. I have to repair a lot.
Every 2 to 3 years, Ramli changes the motto of his rickshaw. And that's what almost all the 400 riders do here.
I chose the unicorn because there is nothing like it. I'll be the only one, something very special. Then I'll make lots of money again. At least I hope so.
Ramli shares the warehouse and workshop with 20 other rickshaw drivers.
Hey, look, I want to decorate everything with unicorns this time. What do you think of that?
The painter thinks it's a good idea. He reckons that unicorns suit Ramli. And he likes the colors. Modern Malacca rickshaws need a lot of energy. Ramli wants to install about 1,000 LED lights plus a high wattage music system.
I have already prepared this for the decoration. We'll put flowers and bright fairy lights on it. We also store our batteries here and charge them. It's important that we always have enough spare batteries. My colleague is using the Ice Princess this year. He only ever drives it at night because it glows so beautifully. This one has opted for Ben 10. Here we also have Pony, Hello Kitty, and Minnie Mouse.
Ramli works as a self-employed small businessman, like everyone here. Most of them have formed a cooperative and help each other. Ramli wants everything in white, even the frame.
I really want to be finished before the holidays start tomorrow, because that's the time for us to earn money. Last year I was too late. This time it has to work, and hopefully I'll be right with the unicorn.
Everyone seems to be in a good mood. The neighbor also has new ideas for his business every year. He sells coconuts.
Good work, nice and white.
But simply offering only coconuts, that doesn't work in Malacca. Here the customers expect something special.
Ready?
He therefore sells them well peeled and well shaken.
Yeah. Okay, cara dia nak melambat
mana? Okay.
Okay. Yes, set, go! Angkat besar barang tu. Barang tu angkat. Yes, set, go! Ya, eh! Say it, go! Hai, set, go! Ya, eh, go! Hai, ya, set, ya, eh! Ya, eh, go! Ya, set, ha, eh! Ya, so! Thank you very much.
He wishes Ramli good luck.
He is my friend. We learn a lot from each other, show each other what we are up to, and give each other tips so that we've become even better.
Off the coast lies the Strait of Malacca, one of the busiest sea passages in the world. Several hundred ships pass through the strait every day, around a quarter of global maritime trade. But danger lurks in the narrow passage between Indonesia and Malaysia. Pirates. In this section of the Strait of Malacca alone, there were 31 pirate attacks last year. And that's why a special Malaysian Coast Guard unit patrols here every day. Salman Bahari is the head of the task force.
Our job is to ensure safety at sea.
Mengawal.
We protect the ships from attacks and raids by pirates. We show presence and are able to intervene quickly.
The men discover a small fishing boat off the island of Kuku. It is bobbing around where there is no fishing normally. One of the men on board even appears to be masked. Pirates use boats like this to hide loot or store weapons.
Control materials.
There could be stolen goods on board, machinery, iron, oil, petrol, illegal things. We will now inspect everything.
First, they check the hooded man. But he says the cap is just a sun protection.
Look under the tarpaulins.
For their raids, pirates use small speedboats. And for their prey, a fishing boat like this would be the ideal hiding place.
So far, everything is good. We haven't found anything suspicious, but we're not done yet. We really have to search everywhere. The other day, we discovered stolen iron under a false bottom.
But there are no stolen goods on this boat. The special unit's next target, the narrow passage of the Indonesian island of Karimun.
These barges have no crew. They are only towed by a tugboat. That's why they can be easily plundered. Even in broad daylight, there is looting. The pirates climb up unnoticed from behind and take everything that's not nailed down.
The special unit was founded in 2004. With success, the confiscated pirate boats are stored at the base, small and maneuverable with powerful engines. 6 more have been added in the past 2 months alone. Penang Island. It was called the Pearl of the Orient by the British. In colonial times, it was the most important trading post in the region. Today, the island's capital, Georgetown, is Malaysia's second largest city. The city center is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. On the outskirts of the city, old so-called clan settlements stand on stilts in the sea. Each of them is still inhabited by members of a single family. Georgetown is the cultural capital of Malaysia. The people maintain their centuries-old rituals. Especially spectacular, the lion dance. On stilts, up to 3 meters high. Lion dances are an almost 2,000-year-old tradition. They are said to drive away evil spirits and bring good luck. The Thang-Loong group is one of 50 lion dance troops in Penang. Pao Tan is responsible for the perfect choreography. He leads the group and used to be a lion acrobat himself.
The dance originally comes from China, but the stilts were invented here in Malaysia. The lions used to dance on tables. At some point, someone had the idea to make it more spectacular and have the lions dance on stilts. Now it is imitated all over the world.
Today's training is a premiere, because 13-year-old Ka and 18-year-old Neo are experienced lion dancers, but they've never been on stilts together. They are to form the new team for this season.
The most difficult thing is to go backwards. You can't see anything, and if you're even a little bit wrong, you crash.
It actually becomes dangerous as soon as they step on the stilts. And it's enough if one of them makes a tiny mistake. Then they both fall. They really have to work together perfectly. Remember, always balance the weight of the other. Only then will you not fall.
Even centimeters can be decisive. Before a newcomer is allowed on the stilts for the first time, he has to train hard for at least a year.
I was really shaking the first time we jumped together, but with time it went well. It's a strange feeling to work with someone you don't know yet, but I think we'll manage. I hit my arm against the stilts a few times. We still have to improve our processes.
More body tension. I don't like your movements yet. They are not cat-like enough yet. They still have to become much more supple and precise.
And the most difficult part is yet to come, dancing in the lion costume. Ka can move the lion's mouth, ears and eyes. And he has to master that later during the breakneck jumps.
Right, right, center, left. Precise and fast movements.
In the Matang mangrove forest, hundreds of transport boats are on the move every day. They bring 300 to 400 tons of wood supplies to the coal kilns. But there can be no talk of logging. The forest has been sustainably managed since 1906. It's divided into 30 sections, and only one of them may be cleared each year. Then mangroves are replanted there and left alone for 30 years. A cycle. Today, Iwan has taken around 5 tons of the best quality mangrove from the forest. The logs now go into the kiln and are set up according to a very specific system so that they char evenly later. Only Ivan's colleague Zufin is allowed to stack. He does nothing else.
For 37 years already, I'm well cooked. I don't mind the heat in here anymore.
Temperature, oxygen supply, cooling process. Any mistake could make the whole batch worthless. One kiln can hold 70 tons of mangrove wood. One of the kilns is now being opened by Iwan and his mother. The right moment is crucial. There are no thermometers in the kilns, no measuring equipment. And once opened, nothing can be corrected.
Maybe we opened this oven a little too early. Maybe the coal is still a bit too warm. It's a bit different every time. It depends on the air pressure and the weather. But at first glance, the quality looks okay.
Seventy tons of wood bring 13 tons of coal. A family business. Ivan's cousin, his aunt, and a sister help with the work. Even his grandfather produced sea coal.
When it's too warm, the coal is still very fragile. So we have to be careful when we take it out and work very carefully.
It takes 3 hours to empty the oven. Customers are already waiting outside. The wholesaler sells the coal to Korea and Japan. Depending on the quality, it can fetch up to 800 euros a ton.
Here you can see that the coal is shiny, and that is very good. Lower quality coal is dull. You can only use it for barbecuing. But good quality is shiny. It can be sold at a higher price. It is suitable for medical products. The dull one, only for barbecue.
The customer is satisfied. Iwan and his mother can call it a day. Their daily wage, just under 10 euros each, and a bag of coal.
We think it's nice that we work together as a family and earn money.
We don't earn much, but we don't care. The main thing is work.
And we even enjoy it.
The fresh mangrove wood is now burning in the stove next door. It takes 30 days. Then there is new sea coal. The tropical waters around Malaysia are rich in fish. More than 100,000 families live from fishing. Most of them live on the west coast of the Malay Peninsula. The village of Kukup is the southernmost point of Malaysia. The Strait of Malacca ends here. Indonesia lies within sight. Salman and his special unit are still on pirate patrol. They have tracked down a suspicious tanker, the Hawk's Glory. The ship is anchored in the middle of the shipping channel.
Motor tanker Hawk's Glory, motor tanker Hawk's Glory, this is Malaysian Coast Guard calling you on channel 16.
The tanker doesn't respond to radio calls.
Motor tanker Hawk's Glory, this is Malaysian Coast Guard. Hawk's Glory, this is Malaysian Coast Guard calling you on channel 06.
In recent years, tankers have been attacked and hijacked time and again. Pirates once killed four seamen.
Hawk's Glory, repeat your last message.
The men decide, approach by dinghy. Still, no sign of life.
We will board the ship for further inspection regarding the problem here. Anything that we find suspicious or wrongdoing, we might take it to our office.
Suddenly, sailors appear. They say it was an engine failure and they didn't hear the radio.
You never know if it's true. It's better to check as soon as something seems suspicious. We must always be vigilant and eliminate any risk. Word of our presence gets around. Most crews are grateful for it, and the pirates know we are there.
And indeed, this time it was only a problem with the engine. On the way back to the harbour, the Coast Guard notices a fishing boat.
Come over here. Where is your life jacket?
Always on duty for the safety of the Strait of Malacca, not only when hunting pirates. Thank you. Ramli, the rickshaw driver, has a long night ahead of him. His newly styled vehicle should have been ready by now, but not even all the unicorns have been mounted yet.
Change of plan. I think it will take a few more hours, but my rickshaw will be really beautiful, and the fairy lights are about to be added. Then it will really shine. It's always worth spending a lot of time on it.
The new design costs Ramli 4,000 ringgit, the equivalent of just under 1,000 euros, including installation and electrics. He gets help from Nasri, the styling expert. He used to be a rickshaw driver. He was the first to pimp his rickshaw like this.
I set a real trend back then. Then more and more riders asked me if I could help them convert their rickshaws as well. Now that's my job, professional rickshaw designer.
Early in the morning, it's done. Mickey Mouse is now a unicorn.
We worked until 4 o'clock. Then I could go home for a while. It was more work than I thought. The lights and the wiring of the music system took a while.
Tonight is the market in Malacca. Then he'll see whether the unicorn bike is a hit with the customers. The east coast of the peninsula is hardly populated. Here on the Pacific Ocean, the dream beaches are wide and lonely. One of the oldest rainforests in the world, Taman Negara, is located here. Today is a big day for Paul. A hotel owner has hired the lion dance troupe.
They have booked us to cleanse the place. The lions are supposed to drive away the evil spirits in the house and bring luck and wealth. Of course, it's also an event for the guests.
Anyone who is self-respecting will have the lions dance at least once a year. The new lion duo has been practicing every day. Today is their first public appearance.
Think about the moves. How do you feel today? Fit enough?
I'm still nervous, unfortunately.
During the lion dance season, we sometimes have 3 to 4 performances a day. From now on, everything has to be perfect. No more mistakes must happen.
If the lion falls from the stilts, it means a bad omen for the future of the hotel. And the reputation of Paul's lion dance troupe would be ruined. The dance lasts almost 10 minutes.
I am relieved. First time together and no big mistake. And really beautiful movements.
Car and Neo have made it. The hotel is free of all evil spirits. And the owner has already hired the troupe again for next year. In the very north of Malaysia lies the island of Langkawi, with national parks, karst rocks, wide beaches, and dense jungle. Is also known for a special marine product, sea cucumber oil. Dried sea cucumbers are the basis for it. Aisha Tok is one of the last masters of oil brewing. She takes a whole handful today.
The quality is really very good, I can tell by the smell. They don't stink. Sea cucumber oil is good for stomach aches and for traditional Malaysian massage. You can also drink it when you're in pain. It actually cures everything.
Charred herbs and woods are the base ingredients. And of course, sea cucumbers.
I add a dash of cooking oil.
But Aisha's secrets are the fresh turmeric leaves from her garden.
They make up the special fragrance and they make sure that the bad air escapes during the massage. We call this angin, and it is important in Malaysian massage.
Once a month, Aisha brews her oil. She sells a bottle for 1 ringgit, about 20 cents. Amy wonders whether the oil is ready.
Yes, just now, it's even still warm.
Amy loves the smell of it. She's a regular customer, as she's the village massage therapist.
It lasts about a year.
Amy says that the oil works wonders for the traditional massage, because she can really massage the bad air out with it. Amy's been booked by a neighbor for a massage in her own home.
Hello, Carol. Hello.
A dab of sea cucumber oil is enough. The client had a car accident 2 years ago. Since then, she's booked Amy's air softening massage once a month.
Sorry. I press here and then the bad air comes out of me, and with it, what's causing her problems.
The air come out.
I notice she has a headache today. That's why a lot comes out here, right?
That's why I headache. Correct?
I only do that with my finger. Everything's fine here.
If you have no. Nothing. Excuse me. Harap maaf.
Yeah.
That sound is awful, like a frog. You must be in real pain.
The customer feels warm. The pain is getting less and less. She feels much better now, she says.
With foreigners, I suppress the noises. I have to pull myself together because they don't like that sound.
The sound.
After 60 minutes of sea cucumber therapy, the air is out. The Keklok Sea is one of the largest Buddhist temple complexes in Southeast Asia, built in 1890 on Penang Island. Around Chinese New Year, it is illuminated by 100,000 lights for a month. The pagoda combines different styles, Chinese, Thai, and Burmese. In Malacca, the night market has begun. Every weekend, thousands of visitors come to the city for it. Now, at the beginning of the holiday season, business is booming, and the traders can finally show off what they've come up with. It's also getting serious for the rickshaw drivers now. Ramli has fully charged 4 car batteries. Now it'll show whether the only unicorn rickshaw from Malacca will go down well. Already after 5 minutes, the first female customers. And the first 10 ringgit. Ramli gets a good 2 euros for the 20-minute tour. The music concept is tried and tested. Chinese pop for Chinese. Indian pop for Indians.
That's how I like it. People seem to be waiting for the unicorn. I think I'm making good money with it. My investment will hopefully pay off.
The third ride, this time with Malay clientele and the current Melayu hit. The sound of Malaysia. All of Asia in one country.